Hello friends, welcome to Rapid Revision for Computer Science students. In this lecture, in this section of undecidability, this is the part 5 and this is the last lecture of decidable and undecidable problems of Turing machine and programming languages. So let's get started friends. The following problems about Turing machine is undecidable, that is first is halting problem of Turing machine, second is state entry problem, and third is checking whether the Turing machine accepts string epsilon or not. So halting problem of Turing machine, it means that checking whether by reading string x Turing machine halts or not. This problem is undecidable for recursive enumerable language, and halting problem is decidable for recursive languages. Second is state entry problem. As the name suggests, by reading string x whether the Turing machine enters a particular state q or not. This problem is undecidable similarly as the first point. This problem is undecidable for recursive enumerable languages, and this problem is decidable for recursive languages. Third point says that checking whether Turing machine accepts string epsilon or not, and this is proved by Rice's theorem. Fourth point is that checking whether Turing machine accepts regular language or not. This is undecidable. Fifth, checking whether Turing machine accepts CFGs or not. Sixth is checking whether Turing machine accepts recursive languages or not. All these are undecidable. The following problems about Turing machine is decidable. First is checking whether Turing machine having 2018 states or not. Second is checking whether Turing machine takes 100 steps or not on some input. Third is checking whether Turing machine accepts string x or not within 2018 steps or some finite number of steps. Fourth is checking whether Turing machine takes at least 100 steps or not on some input. Fifth is same, but it is for all the inputs. That is checking whether Turing machine takes at least 100 steps or not on all the inputs. These are decidable. Now heading towards the programming languages. The following problems about programming language are undecidable. First is checking whether given two programs produce same output or not for the same input. Second is checking whether the given program ever produces an output. Third is checking whether the given program can loop forever or not on some input. Next is post correspondence problem. It is a particular kind of problem in which we are given two sets. And we have to make the string such that we have to take an ordered pair of both the sets, and we have to derive a particular string from both the upper denominator and numerator, and you can use any pair any number of times. So this is a particular kind of problem. You can also see the video which I will be adding the link. And from there you will be able to solve the question based on post correspondence problem. In this lecture we are going to discuss whether it is decidable or not. So let me tell you that post correspondence problem is recursive enumerable but not recursive. Hence it is undecidable. Why is it undecidable? Because modified post correspondence problem is reducible to P. In modified post correspondence problem, you have in the solution there is a mandatory condition that the first symbol must be started from the first string of both the sets. So modified post correspondence problem is reducible to post correspondence problem. MCPP, that is most modified post correspondence problem, is undecidable problem. Since MPCP is reducible to PCP, MPCP is smaller problem, it is undecidable, therefore PCP is also undecidable. Both PCP and MPCP are decidable if the list contains one element only. And this is the condition that I have to tell you what is partial decidable or semi-decidable situation. A language is said to be partially decidable if it is recursive enumerable language but not recursive language. Then it is known as partially decidable languages, and recursive languages are known as decidable languages, while not RELs or not recursive enumerable languages are undecidable languages. So this is really important, and that may come into exams. Okay, partial decidability terminology you must be familiar with. Now next, this is the last diagram that we are going to deal with. In this diagram, the lowermost one or the simple set is regular language, then DCFL is there, then CFL, CSLs, then P. P problems include sorting algorithms, NP problems include 01 knapsack, which is time complexity of approximately exponential, that is 2 to the power n, then recursive language, which is NP hard problem, and then recursive enumerable languages. For the time complexity, they may also come in the exams. For P class, it is deterministic algorithm, that is sorting algorithm, and the time complexity is ordered of n to the power k. For NP and NP complete problems, that is order of 2 to the power n, that is exponential, and NP hard problems have time complexity greater than order of 2 to the power n. So hope that all the videos, all the slides are comfortable to you and everything is crystal clear to you. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like, comment and subscribe. Bye for now. Thank you.